With the way people are talking about Pokemon Sword and Shield, you would think that they are the worst games ever made. People have been unbelievably upset at the two most recent entries into the Pokemon franchise. And while some of that anger is well placed, I honestly think that most of it is really just wrong. Now, I already know some people are going to be commenting saying, oh, you're just a blank fanboy, you'll always buy whatever the Pokemon company puts out, and you can't see anything wrong in their game. And that is just so incredibly wrong on so many levels, but the people who are commenting that probably won't be listening to Logic anyway, so I'll just leave them alone. However, what I do want to say is I do have enough content to make kind of the inverse video of this. 5 reasons why Pokemon Sword and Shield will be terrible games. I just like focusing on the positives more than the negatives, but if there is enough interest down in the comments below, I will make that video in the coming weeks. With that out of the way, let's get into why I think Pokemon Sword and Shield are going to be amazing games. Specifically, I got 5 reasons, ranging from gameplay mechanics, to the presentation, to even some stuff that Game Freak hasn't officially announced yet. Stick around, it's gonna be a good one. What's up guys, it's Thomas from the Switch Shop, and let's get into why I think these games are actually going to be really good, or at least why I'm excited for them. First up is the graphics, and the graphics for these games, I'm going to be honest, they used to kind of suck. I was one of those people who saw the first trailer and was extremely disappointed in the way these games looked. I think it was a mix between my expectations being too high, given that this was the first mainline Pokemon game that was going to be in HD, and the fact that the game, honest to God, just didn't look good. But in the first few trailers, I was not sold on this game's presentation at all. However, since I've kept an open mind, I've really started to come around on it. Mainly because, honest to God, Game Freak has been working their ass off to polish up the graphics. In the first trailer, everything was pixely, geometry looked just honest to God awful, and the textures were pretty abhorrent. I even made a video where I talked about this. However, that was then and this is now, and now this game looks really, really clean. The towns and the civilizations of this game just look phenomenal. The amount of detail is something we've never seen in Pokemon before. And it's really exciting to be able to explore this brand new region that I honestly think now is taking advantage of the Switch's graphical capability. Moving on to the second thing that has me extremely excited. This is actually stuff that Game Freak hasn't announced yet. They've been a lot more secretive in terms of this game's press hype cycle. Normally, Game Freak will announce a lot about the story, basically spoil a fair amount of it. We'll know almost all of the new Pokemon going into the game. On top of that, we'll generally know all of the gym leaders, what post-game content we'll find, all of the new features, and all of the evolutions, especially for the starters. I'm gonna be honest, I don't think we know any of that. We know some new features, but we don't know all the new Pokemon. In fact, we've only really seen like 10 or 20. We're still yet to see the starters' even middle evolutions, much less their final evolutions. We only know a couple of the gym leaders, we really don't know anything about the story, and it's these kind of secrets that make me really excited. For those of you guys who don't know, I'm not the biggest Pokemon fan. I've played a few of the games here and there, but I'm definitely not diehard. My first experience with the franchise was with Pokemon Sapphire, best generation by the way, when my grandma got the game for me from a garage sale, and I literally had no idea what it was. Discovering everything from the systems, to the mechanics, to the different Pokemon, to the story, that was honestly one of my greatest gaming experiences. And I feel like most people have had an experience like that, especially with Pokemon. While Sword and Shield won't be able to rekindle all of that magic, the fact that so much is still shrouded in mystery has me really excited. Next thing I want to talk about is the story. While we don't know much about it, it's shaping up to be really interesting. A lot of that has to do with just the Galar region as a whole. The whole stadium-esque settings and the fact that the Pokemon League is actually like a sports league, all that's really cool. On top of that, Team Yell looks like a pretty interesting team, and the different trainers they've showed off are actually really interesting. Leon, the strongest trainer in the Galar region, looks like an actually intimidating rival. Then you got your friendly rival, Hop. The different gym leaders look really cool, and I cannot shake the feeling that this Chairman Rose guy is gonna turn out to be bad at the end. This is the most promising a Pokemon story has been for a long time. Jumping into the new Pokemon, we don't know a ton of them, as I mentioned before, but what we do know is pretty interesting. First of all, I'd like to get this out of the way. The starters are pretty good, and the legendaries are awesome. I love the way the legendaries look. On top of that, the new Pokemon we've seen are pretty cool too. Obviously, you got the standouts like Wooloo, Yamper, and Morpeku, but we've also got some pretty cool Alolan forms, such as Alolan Weezing, Alolan Ponyta, and Alolan Zigzagoon, which evolves into a brand new Pokemon, Obstagoon. The fact that there are over 800 Pokemon made now, and they're still coming up with designs that are honestly really unique, that surprises me. I think the one I'm looking forward to playing with the most is Drednaw. He just looks so badass. Alright, the last thing I want to talk about is kind of a cop-out because it's new features. And there are a lot of new features that I wanted to talk about, so many that I had to kind of combine them all into one point so I could fit into this 5-point limit I set for myself. New features such as Pokéjobs, Gigantislash Dynamaxing, raid battles which you could do with online friends, and stuff like trainer cards are really all unique and just go to show how the Pokemon Company is really taking this game to the next level. You also got some of the cheesy stuff like that curry dex, which is honestly a pretty interesting way to add more content to a Pokemon game. Overall, there are a ton of new features. This isn't just another by-the-numbers Pokemon game like the ones we got on 3DS. There's a lot of new stuff here that has me really excited. So those are the 5 reasons I think Pokemon Sword and Shield could be amazing games. Let me know if you guys agree down in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button to show your support, because no matter what videos I make on Pokemon Sword and Shield, I already know they're gonna get disliked. So if you did enjoy the video, a like would be appreciated now more than ever. Thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe if you're new, all that good stuff. I'm Thomas from the Switch Stop, signing off. Peace.